Google, you know, we've talked a lot about Google Glass, but even before most people are on the Google Glass, Google contact lenses are on the way. We've got an image, how it works. The Google contact lens contains a control circuit, an image capture camera component, and an image sensor. It can be wirelessly linked to a mobile phone for data access and to issue commands via audio. The system will be able to detect faces, potentially allowing the blind to recognize people. Okay, so there's a lot of good stuff. The medical stuff helping the blind, obviously great. So we've talked a lot about Google Glass here, and I'm a firm believer it's gonna completely change how we all act. If you wear glasses right now, because they already have that it's gonna be able to be put in designer glasses, you're gonna be able to be recording us. Imagine if I felt like I was
being recorded right now. You're still gonna have to have something more than yeah, I know.
That would be
very upsetting.
That would be terrible. But it seems like we're already skipping ahead. Like, we're going to have Google Glass for like a couple months.
Yeah.
And, you know, some people have it already, but we're going to have it for a couple months. And then bang, it's
going to
be
in
contact lenses. Is this scary? People always say, well, Dave, you're against science when I do this. You're against technology because I don't want to be recorded at every second. What do you think?
I'm split on this because at first I'm like, oh, this is super like Logan's Run, and then they're gonna like pop my eyeball out when I get to a certain age. It's gonna be horrible.
Yeah.
But then it's like, you know.
You're already at that age.
It's too late.
Seriously, go fuck yourself. But then it's like you think about like cochlear implants and all this stuff that makes deaf people be able to hear. And if this is that, if this can be that for blind people, they're talking about. I don't know. I didn't realize so many people are having problems with diabetes. But
yeah.
They said that to regulate their glucose, uh-huh. This is going to be really helpful. That's cool. But is that what this is really about? I doubt it.
Right. Somehow this will really be about porn, right?
Yeah,
isn't that how it all goes? That porn leads the way with technology.
I'm not sold on Google Glass. I've been wrong on a lot of stuff. I think until I see something that indicates, people want to distort their faces. And right now, it's a facial distortion.
Yeah.
Do you think it'll go the way of the laser disc?
It might. I mean, it's not like we've had, like, it'll work in some, but walking around having to touch your glasses, like, there's going to come a point where it's too upsetting into our regular lives.
Right.
And right now, Google Glass looks like it. I get it. There's going to be some cool component. There might be some time that you want to do it.
Yeah. Well, I wasn't kidding. I mean, they're already making designer glasses.
They are.
So it's not as obtrusive.
But it still has to have the camera.
Right. But people who are wearing Google Glasses want you to know they're wearing Google Glasses.
Right. So we're reading the story on it, and like in paragraph 9, what it was included in your list there, Dave, is like. And it might also help the contact lenses, might also help the blind see. And I'm like,
they really buried that lead.
I would have led with that. I would have opened with, we can cure blindness.
Yeah. You think that's more important?
Yeah, maybe. Wow. No,
that's a big deal.
That's a thing.
Yeah, that actually was second to glucose, checking your glucose.
Yeah, yeah, because that's what they were invented for, to read the glucose for diabetics so they can constantly monitor the levels, which you mentioned, because it can be read in the tears.
That's fascinating. Yeah.
All right, so I think what you're both saying is I should stop being so fearful of where this all leads, or I've just watched so many science fiction movies and smoked so much pot at the same time that I always see everything where the robots come get us.
I don't doubt that at all, that you've done that.
Yeah.
But here's the thing, if I'm holding my phone, I'm probably recording you. So it's like, what? Just as a public service to you.
Yeah.
But that's the thing, it's like you say, I don't want to be recorded, I don't want to, you know, it's making you paranoid, but we're already being recorded all the time, whether you like it or not, whether you know it or not. So how are the glasses any different?
Yeah. Do you think we're going to have places ultimately, I think they've been popping up already, I think there's a bar in Portland where they're banning Google Glass, but do you think we're going to have like technology-free zones,
yes.
like where
Ooh,
you're going to go to dinner and they're going to literally take your phone and that, yeah?
Yeah, there already are some. There's places that I went to work, a little office place. I mean, it's not technology free because everybody there is working on their screenplay on their computers.
Yep.
But I mean, you can't talk on the phone. There can't be any noise. And I think there'll be more of that. I just like 3D glasses, like 3D TVs, and maybe that will take over. But in the moment that you make people watch television or watch a movie and force them to put heavy glasses on, force them to put something on their face, I just think it's different. I'm prepared to be wrong, but my hunch is that something will get in the way of it.
Yeah, well, that's just the small step before the contact lenses, and then that may be the proof that.
But also, who can touch their eye? I mean, I know there's a lot of contact lens wearers, but Jesus, how do you people do that?
Have you ever worn contacts?
Oh, yeah, I wore them for years. I still wear them to play, you know, when I decided to be an athlete.